turmoil. What were the situations? The first of all, bad harvesting due to severe winter. Second, rising of price of bread. Exploitation by the bakers of the situation and hoarding of supplies. These situations was very painful to the common people, especially to the members of the third estates. After spending hours in long queues at the bakery, crowds of angry women stormed into the shops. Women had to stand for a long time at bakery to get bread. This standing for long time on the bakery stormed the women. At the same time, the king ordered troops to move into the Paris, as we saw in previous section also. On 14th July, the agitated crowd stormed and destroyed the Versailles. Dear students, in previous class also we discussed about the Versailles. Versailles was a prison of France. The prisoners were kept there, and it was standing as the symbol of despotic power. That's why common people hated it. So, on 14th July, the agitated crowd attacked on Versailles and stormed it. In the countryside, without participation of countryside or village, any revolution does not become success. That's why in France also the countryside's rumors spread from village to village that the lords of the manor had hired bands of brigands who were on their way to destroy the ripe crops. This rumors was spread that lords had hired brigades or soldiers to destroy the ripe crops. It caught in a frenzy of fear. It means it feared the peasants, the farmers. Peasants in several districts seized hoes and pitchforks and attacked chatyoks. Chatyoks means building or castle of king or a nobleman where they live. Thus we see that with this rumor, or this rumor forced the peasants to hold hoe and pitchforks to attack on the chatyoks. Several they looted hoarded grain of the noblemen, burned down documents containing records of manorial dues, a large number of nobles fled from their homes. Many of them migrated to neighboring countries. In this situation, several noblemen fled from their homes. Many of them took shelter in neighboring countries. Faced with the power of his revolting subjects, Louis XVI finally accorded recognition to the National Assembly and accepted the principle that his power would from now on be checked by a constitution. It means agitation of the people forced Louis XVI to recognize the National Assembly and to approve the new constitution, which would limit the power of monarch. On the night of 4 August 1789, the Assembly passed a decree to abolish the feudal system of obligations and taxes. It means on 4th August 1789, this new National Assembly passed a proposal which abolished the feudal system of obligation and taxes that was imposed in Versailles meeting in the State General. Members of the clergy were forced to give up their villages. Members of the clergy were forced to leave the village or to give up their village. Tithes were abolished. Lands owned by church were confiscated. As a result, the government acquired assets worth at least 2 billion livres. Dear students, often a question is asked that what changes the new constitution brought in France. Then, first of all, the new constitution limited the powers of monarch. It abolished the feudal system of obligation. It abolished the taxes imposed by State General. It forced the clergy members or clergy to give up the privileges. It forced the clergy to leave the land, and as a result, the government acquired assets worth at least 2 billion livres. It means the church or clergy owned the property or wealth was of 2 billion livres. According to this constitution, all the property of members of clergy came into the hands of government.